I'm Aaron Baker from PhoneDog.com, and it's part two of the LG Lucid 2 full video review on PhoneDog. Is this the ultimate mid-range Android device, or should you splurge a little bit and maybe get the HTC One or the Note 2 or the Galaxy S4 when it arrives on Verizon Wireless? We'll find out in the full video review, which starts right now. It's part two of a review of the LG Lucid 2 on Verizon Wireless, a device that's free with 2-year agreement. And even though you can get some nice goodies like a wireless charger for about $80 additional, it comes with a back and with a charger as well, which LG was kind enough to send over. Even with the goodies, it's still a nicely priced Android smartphone with some decent mid-range specifications that'll appeal to a lot of people. Before we get into that, special thanks to our partners at Best Buy Mobile for giving us devices like the Lucid 2 and the HTC One and the Note 2 and all those good devices for use in our One Pod Bandit giveaway game. When you walk into Best Buy Mobile, you won't have to deal with biasness. All the reps are unbiased. So whether it's Verizon, AT&T, Sprint, T-Mobile, whatever works best and whatever you need the most, they'll make sure you walk out with the best solution for you and your life at Best Buy Mobile. So let's do a quick recap in part two. Specs wise here, we've got a 1.2 gigahertz dual core Snapdragon S4 CPU, 4.3 inch display that's QHD 540 by 960 pixels, 5 megapixels, 1080p HD recording, 2460 milliamp hour battery, a gig of RAM, Android 4.1 Jelly Bean with LG's user interface. Now, in part one, we talked about personalization, and I'm gonna pick it up in part two with personalization as well by taking a look at settings. I'm going to display here, and you can see font type as well. So there are a lot of options for you to customize this device and really make it your own. So don't feel like you have to go with Samsung or you have to go with HTC to get that personalization fix. There are quite a few goodies in here as well, and comparatively speaking, the price is far cheaper. Now, this has 4G capabilities on Verizon Wireless, and the battery is getting low, so we got to wrap this up as quickly as possible. 5%, and I'm not near a charger. What's going to happen? Don't you love that kind of suspense? Kansas, let's try to change the server if we can, but if not, we may just roll with it until GPS locks on and change that to megabits per second. Verizon quotes download speeds, 5 megabits per second, 2 to 5 megabits per second on the upload, and like I said, 5 to 12 on the download. So you get that pretty much nationwide, and you can see their network is obviously the most saturated 4G LTE network out of any of the major 4 wireless carriers, but still decent specs or decent speeds all around. You can see here 17.9 megabits per second on the download, 6 megabits per second on the upload, blows past the 5 to 12 megabit per second number that they quote in their press stuff, and then upload 6.92 past the 5 megabit per second mark as well. So we'll do one more speed test so you can take a look. Again, more in line with expectations, but still very impressive considering how saturated the LTE network is comparatively speaking versus other devices or other carriers on the market. So decent specs there. Let's take a look at Quadrant Standard as well. Now, Quadrant Standard, take it with a grain of salt. It's not indicative of day-to-day performance. I find this device to be relatively quick all around. It's not necessarily as fast as the Galaxy S4 when I played with it internationally, or the HTC One, both the international version and the Sprint demo unit that I have. They're pretty speedy devices all around, but this device is impressive for the price point. And keeping in mind, this is gonna be great for either a secondary smartphone maybe for you, or a device for mom or dad or grandma. Smartphones are where the party's at now. Quote that, and remember that, because that's an Aaron Baker quote right there. Smartphones where the party's at, and this is gonna be a great device for a lot of people, and wireless charging is definitely picking up, and you can get goodies like this. And it's nice to see that even for mid-range phones, they're supporting it with an accessory ecosystem, which I like a lot. Now, I showed this off in part one. This is also an additional goodie that LG sent over, an additional battery charger. So if you have a spare battery, you can pop it right down here in the back. Then, of course, you've got your USB charging area there, and then you've got the device itself, or the accessory itself here. So the device slots down in here. Now, keep in mind, you do have to have the original back cover on this device in order for it to fit in the dock. If you have the wireless charging one on, which I do right now, it does not fit into the dock. So these are all some additional accessories that you can get for this device. So 5,503 on Quadrant Standard, very impressive score considering the mid-range status of this device. Now I want to take a look at the camera as well and see 5 megapixel camera, 1080p HD recording. Let's see what we can snap a picture of. Maybe the ASUS PadFone 2, just since it happens to be lying around here. doing nothing, just being lazy this morning. Battery level's too low to turn on the camera. Let's go ahead and get that plugged. During that quick break, I put in the other spare battery because I forgot I charged it a couple of days ago and used it in some brief testing. So we'll take a look at the camera here. And also what I did is put the normal battery cover back on the device so you could see what it looked like in the dock. So that's what it looks like in the dock accessory. Easy to fit in, easy to use all around. So we'll pull this out. And then we'll go back to the camera, and I will not show that again. You can see 5-megapixel camera here, 1080p HD video recording capabilities, and you've got some goodies over here on the side, including cheese shutter. We'll go ahead and turn this on. Bam, down here as well, time catch shot, which is particularly useful, missing moment before pressing the shutter. So if I've got, let's do that. Turn that on, and let's see what we've got here. Display the missing moments, press this button, and you could see all the different missing moments here. So kind of like the BlackBerry Z10 feature, kind of like some features we've seen in upcoming devices, the Galaxy S4 as well. We saw that if you remember the hands-on that I did in New York before the launch event. We'll take a look here. I didn't mean to turn that off, turn it back on. And you can see all those different shutter options right there. So you've got that feature, which is a nice one. And then you've got quick menu zoom, brightness, all the typical stuff that you would expect with the camera here. And we'll go through here, make sure that's on, and then we'll bam. Let's see if it got it. Display the missing moments. Press that, and you can see Shazam right there. Check the photos you want to keep. You can see it in the frame. Go ahead and save all those. And then you've got 5 different pictures. So if you're storing, you know, something like a football game, a basketball game, a soccer game, something your kids are doing, and you want to take that quick motion shot, thanks to the Lucid 2, you can take care of that. And hey, again, keeping in mind the price point, not bad whatsoever. So all in all, really nice device. I like the accessory ecosystem as well. Wireless charging is popular. It's beginning to catch on, and you can get the wireless charging accessory with the wireless charging back, which is not this one. It's this one. It's a little bit thicker, but you can get the wireless charging cover. You can get the dock as well, which has room for one additional battery. Great accessories all around, a nice little ecosystem for the Lucid 2. It represents a great addition to LG's lineup, and as LG continues to compete in the US market, I hope they have devices like this, all the way up to the LG Optimus G Pro, hopefully. We've heard rumors of it coming to AT&T. I'd love to see it on the nation's second largest wireless carrier as well. Love to get some high-end, mid-range devices, a little bit of everything, because hey, choice is always good. Keep it locked on phonedog.com for continuing coverage of the LG Lucid 2. Hit me up on Twitter with your thoughts, phonedog_Aaron. Facebook, facebook.com/HiAaronBaker. Google Plus, gplus.to/phonedog, or phonedog.com/gplus. Whatever your heart fancies. Either one of those will get to the same page. Keep it locked on the site for continuing coverage on the Lucid 2. We'll have dogfights and additional coverage on this cute little Android phone with some great accessories to boot. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.